Hi, I'm Zach Lanier, Senior Security Researcher with Duo Labs, the research division of Duo Security, and I'm here today to talk to you about a two-factor authentication bypass in PayPal. So here you'll see that I'm at the PayPal site. I'm going to go ahead and put in the credentials, the primary credentials for this account. I'm going to go ahead and hit login. So you see here I get prompted for a one-time password that would be delivered via SMS. Now, this is just to demonstrate that this account is in fact two-factor enabled. So here I have the PayPal iOS application, and I'm going to go ahead and launch it. So note that when I log in, notice that after supplying my primary credentials, you briefly see my recent activity. It appears as though I'm logged out, and I receive an error message indicating that if I'm using a security key enabled account or two-factor enabled account, the mobile application doesn't support it. Now, what's interesting is that you did in fact see my recent activity for a brief period, which suggests that I was in fact logged in. To prove that we might in fact be logged in and perhaps bypass the two-factor, let's go ahead and try a low-tech workaround here. Notice that I'm swiping up from the bottom to get access to the control center, and I'm going to enable airplane mode right after seeing my account activity. I receive an error that it couldn't reach PayPal's server, which makes sense. I'm not on the network. So I'm going to go ahead and disable airplane mode. Now we'll refresh that just to prove that we are able to update this. And sure enough, it updated. So let's try sending myself some money. So here we have me sending $5 to myself to a different email address with a memo of 2FA bypassed. And sure enough, I'm prompted to confirm this transaction, and $5 just went to myself. If we look at my email at zach@duosecurity.com, we see that there is a confirmation email that I sent myself $5 from paypal@nowhere.org. So after monitoring the requests and responses and other traffic coming out of the mobile application, we decided to go ahead and make our own little fake PayPal client. So with our duopal.py script, we're going to go ahead and supply a username. Once again, we'll use that 2FA-enabled account, paypal@nowhere.org. A recipient, we'll use zach@duosecurity.com one more time. And an amount, we'll send him another $5 this time. So I'm prompted for my primary credentials, or in this case, my password, which I'll enter. And we'll see first that it receives an access token. And this access token is used for OAuth, which is used by PayPal for authentication and authorization. It then receives a bearer token, which is used for subsequent transactions. And finally, a SOAP token, which is used for actually talking to the transaction API. So we'll see here, there's a bunch of information about my wallet, which basically refers to all of the backing payment instruments or cards or bank accounts that I use for my account. Note that a unique identifier, or a UUID in this case, is generated just so that we can correlate that this transaction corresponds to the confirmation email. Now, once this has gone through the final step, or the fourth step in this transaction process, we receive a message that the transaction succeeded, $5 was sent. Shortly, we'll receive an email confirming this, much like before. So here I have opened the email indicating that the payment was a success. And if we look, there's a client-side ID, or that UUID that we saw earlier, that starts with DA979 and then ends with something like BCDC63. What this ultimately means is that PayPal's two-factor authentication is somewhat moot. PayPal was one of the first vendors to implement two-factor authentication for consumers on this large of a scale. As a broader point, two-factor authentication is, of course, a really good thing. But implementation flaws like this give rise to vulnerabilities that really subvert and impact that strong protection.